Hello, today is Sunday, August 31st. This presentation will look back at the temperature and precipitation numbers for the month of August so far, and also a quick summary of the meteorological summer of June, July, and August. Then we will look ahead to the Climate Prediction Center's outlook for September and the fall season of September, October, and November. Finally, we will downscale that outlook to a few selected sites in this forecast area. Here's a quick synopsis of the 2014 monsoon season so far. An operational definition of the monsoon is a south flow that pulls subtropical moisture northward through the desert southwest and into this region. This summer, monsoonal moisture began to work north of the Four Corners right around the 4th of July. There were 2 week surges of moisture centered on the 10th and 24th of July, then a stronger surge centered on July 29th. Monsoon surges continued regularly through August, producing a wet month across the forecast area. The next surge was forecast to begin on September 4th. And here is an August summary of precipitation and temperatures at area airports through the 30th. In the top portion of this slide, you can see precipitation values for area airports with departure from normal values in parentheses. All sites recorded above normal precipitation except at Durango's airport. In fact, at 3.16 inches, Grand Junction has had the third wettest August on record, behind only the Augusts of 1921 and 1957. The bottom portion of the slide shows that August showers brought cooler than normal temperatures. Here is a summer season summary of precipitation and temperatures that includes the months of June, July, and August. June is climatologically our driest month of the year, and June 2014 was drier than normal. As we have already seen, monsoon moisture arrived in July with a mixture of above and below normal precipitation recorded for that month, followed by heavy showers in August. In the top portion of this slide, you can see summer season precipitation totals for area airports with departure from normal values in parentheses. Most airports reported above normal precipitation except Aspen, Montrose, and Durango that did not catch up to normal after the dry month of June. The bottom portion of the slide shows that summer's temperatures were split with warmer than normal conditions in the majority for the summer season. Here are annual precipitation graphs for three representative sites in the forecast area: Vernal in northeast Utah, Grand Junction in west central Colorado, and Cortez in southwest Colorado. For most of eastern Utah and western Colorado, September and October are the wettest months of the year. Now turning to the forecast, the most powerful tool for seasonal outlooks is El Niño Southern Oscillation, or ENSO for short. In the equatorial eastern Pacific, between the dateline and the coast of Ecuador, is the Niño 3.4 region outlined here by the red box. Warmer than normal temperatures began to develop in this Niño 3.4 region in May and have remained slightly warmer than normal into late August. This slide shows the mid-August forecast from numerous models of how sea surface temperatures in the Niño 3.4 region will vary from normal through the fall, winter, and spring of 2014-2015 from left to right across the graph. You can see nearly all of the forecast lines are at or above the 0.0 level, indicating a forecast for warmer waters. A majority of the models indicate El Niño conditions will develop this fall, but El Niño looks less certain now than just a month ago. Confidence in an El Niño forecast has recently diminished somewhat. By the way, since 1950, La Niña conditions have never followed an ENSO neutral season like last winter, and this forecast reflects this. Here is the National Climate Prediction Center's outlook for the month of September. The temperature outlook chart on the left shows no forecast skill, with this forecast area in the white EC area representing equal chances of above, near, or below normal temperatures. The right chart shows a shift of probabilities towards a wetter than normal September. But as we saw in August, if precipitation is above normal, most often temperatures will be below normal. Here is the National Climate Prediction Center's outlook for the fall season of September, October, November. The temperature outlook chart on the left shows a trend towards cooler than normal conditions in much of western Colorado, with no forecast skill in eastern Utah. The right precipitation chart continues to show a shift of probabilities towards a wetter than normal fall season. Regionally, here again are annual precipitation graphs in dash black for Vernal, Grand Junction, and Cortez. The red line is the precipitation average of all 18 El Nino seasons since 1950. You can see that during El Nino years, the months of September and October tend to be wetter than normal at these three sites that represent the region. If El Nino conditions do emerge this autumn, here is what happened during the previous four El Nino years. This subset of most recent El Ninos shows a tendency for a wet fall. The four winters shown here tended to be drier than normal, with some periods of good snowfall showing up within only one of the winter months. This concludes this summer climate summary and fall seasonal outlook. The next outlook will be produced in late September. You can follow the National Weather Service in Grand Junction on our website at www.weather.gov/GJT or on Facebook or Twitter. Thank you for listening and have a great autumn.